Welcome to this video, where I will be focusing on Landsat, so the Landsat satellite. Just giving you a really, really brief introduction to what Landsat is, because we'll be using Landsat as an example of raster data for doing calculations in QGIS in a later video. So, first of all, what really makes Landsat an interesting satellite to use is that it is a long series of different satellites. So going back to the 70s, that was the Landsat 1, and at the moment we have the active satellites are the Landsat 8 and to some degree Landsat 7, it having some small data problems, but still somewhat working. And hopefully in the 2021, we will have the Landsat 9 coming up, so next spring. So the thing is that these Landsats, although there has been improved technology, does give us the ability to be somewhat compatible and compare really early images from the 80s and 70s with what we get today. We can look at urban sprawl, deforestation, degradation of natural areas, and whatever we have of different interesting subjects to look at through time. Of course, today we can use satellite to look at also non-historical flow. What is the actual urban heat island problem for Copenhagen at this moment, as we'll be doing in a later video. So, just to give you an idea of what Landsat is, I have these two links. So this one is a time lapse. Normally, I don't use QGIS for processing Landsat data. I normally use this Google Earth engine, which is the engine behind Google Earth, if you wish, which is a really cool tool for doing remote sensing. They have made some time lapses that we can look at. So if we just take, there's different examples that you can click on and look at, and then you, in this case I've taken, so this is Las Vegas. The town of Las Vegas. Also note, when I'm in a moment start the time lapse, the water resources out here, this lake, how it develops at the moment we are looking at the image from 84. So I'll just start the and you can see the time going, the town increasing, and the water resources depleting. And then we'll start the time lapse again. And so we can look at different situations. We can just scroll down and look at, in Brazil, deforestation and how the Amazon area has been taken over by different farm activities. So here we can again see if we stop the video. So this is the 2084, and if I just run it from here, you can see how the deforestation and how the area is converted into agricultural feeds to have soybeans to feed our Danish pigs, or whatever they're used for. You can also choose to navigate to somewhere you find interesting. Let's say Roskilde, Denmark. Because these different changes are not something that only happens abroad. If we look at the local area around Roskilde, we all know the problem of that the Roskilde Festival has to move because of the use of the gravel. So if we start this video here, we can see all the different excavations of gravel area, especially if you note this area over here. See how this has developed through time from agricultural fields to large gravel pits. Or if we go to Copenhagen. and look at, so Vestamar, we have Bella Center here, we have the southern part of the harbor, Copenhagen Harbor down here, and if we look at how the urban development has been of these areas for the time period. So we have lots of situations where looking at Landsat is really an interesting thing, asset to understand urban development. If we look at how to get hold of it, you can, if you're not using Google Earth Engine, you can go to this Earth Explorer, which again, I have a link for here. You'll have to sign in. So there's a sign in, and I am logged in as me. So I have entered my credentials. And again, here we can look for a place. So let's look for good old Roskilde again. And so this is where I'm interested in data from. Basically, a Landsat image covers most of Zealand, so doesn't really matter that much. And we can then say, which period do we want our data to be from? And last year was a really miserable summer. So I'll just, but there was some nice days back in August. So I'll say I want an image from somewhere at the beginning of August to somewhere in the end of September. Okay. I'll be interested in Landsat data, and I'm interested in this collection level 1 data set, and I'm interested in my Landsat 8 data. Okay. I can set extra criteria, and I will that because one of the things that is really important, especially last year, is amount of clouds. So I want an image with not too many clouds on my scene, or if I only was interested over land, I could set the land element. So I specified which time, where it was, how much cloud I can expect, and I'll do a search, and there was only one image. So normally there will be an image for each 7 to 14 days. This time there's only one image, and basically it's the only cloud-free image for the whole of that year. I locate the image, and I can then basically just download it. Ask me what do I want to download, and I want to download the whole shebang as a geotiff. And that, and I want to save it, and it will start downloading the file. So let's look a bit more at what it is this Landsat data is. Now I've shown you some examples for the time lapse and how we easily can collect the data ourselves. Basically, in the satellite, we have a rotating mirror and a sensor. So this, as the satellite moves along, the mirror rotates and then reflects different parts of the surface onto the sensor. The sensor then converts this to digital numbers, so some form of representation of how much energy that was received, so light, to be more in general terms, from a given, and what we'll call a pixel on our satellite data here. The satellite collects at what we call different wavelengths, so different colors. So there will be one set of raster for the blue, one for the green, one for the red, and one for the near infrared, and so on. So we are collecting several different raster layers at the same time over the same area. If we look at this concept of the electromagnetic spectrum, so basically light is electromagnetic energy, we have from these short wavelength to long wavelength. So we have the blue, as it has a, this is the Landsat 8. It has two different sensors on it. It has the thermal infrared, and it has this land observation system here, where we have some different bands. So we have a really called Ultra Blue, which is cloud, really. We have blue, green, red, and then we have what we call panchromatic. So different, all of these merge together with a higher resolution. We have a near infrared, shortwave infrared, so on. So we have different wavelengths. So what we'll do when we have downloaded this is that we can start looking at these different wavelengths and doing strange things with them. So this is basically what the Landsat data is. In following videos, I will start working with the Landsat in QGIS. So hope to see you there. Bye.